choices. For the contestant's choice tonight, we brought out a music maven to help guide the top three. Take a look at this. Roll it.
Her singing talents were discovered around the age of 7.
She thinks she's bad, but don't make me mad.
The rest is history. Beyoncé emerged onto the music scene as the lead singer of the group Destiny's Child in 1997. The group recorded one hit after another, and Beyoncé developed quickly into an iconic force in the music world. She has smashed the common goal of becoming a triple threat 2 times over. Finding tremendous success not only as a singer, actress, and choreographer, but also as a songwriter, producer, director, and fashion designer. And she has styled a career fit for a diva. So she went solo, and her film career ignited in 2002. In 2006, she starred in the blockbuster hit Dreamgirls, and it grossed over $154 million at the box office. She has won 16 Grammy Awards and has sold over 75 million albums worldwide.
Welcome to the Grammys. It's Beyoncé.
And all the while, she's never lost the connection with the fans that have made it all possible.
You must not know about me. You must not know about me.
Whoa! She's a bona fide international megastar. So when looking for a superstar to guide them to the finale, Beyoncé was the irreplaceable choice.
I think the three contestants are unbelievable. They all have something very unique about them, and I feel like it's going to be a really hard decision for America.
I'm going to be listening to your personal picks tonight, so I'm very thrilled to hear them.
Thank you.
Yeah. Let's go do it.
We'll be getting the world premiere of her new music video later in the show. Next, Scotty kicks it off with his favorite song by Lone Star, Idol, live right after this. Back with you live on American Idol. Tonight, you choose who you want in the finale. The first set of songs are chosen by our finalists, and Beyoncé is guiding them along. Here is what she thought about Scotty.
Hello.
How you doing?
I'm great.
So nice to see you.
Scotty boy, that's my boy. He is so incredible. So what are you gonna be singing?
Today I'm singing Amazed by Lone Star.
Oh, I love Lone Star.
Yeah, it's a pretty good one.
He really does have such a charm, and it's so innocent, and he's just a cutie pie.
Every time our eyes meet, this feeling inside me is almost more than I can take.
It's a simple melody that allows for his tone to shine through, and his voice is just so full and warm.
Every little thing that you do, I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting better.
It was interesting to hear him go into his higher range. I hope that he's confident, because I'm not sure if he has to do that because his voice is so wonderful low. Well, I noticed it was going into your higher range. And how comfortable, because it sounded like it was really effortless for you.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I've sang kind of down low for the whole thing. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's just nice to push yourself and see how far you can go.
I think it's very clever that he's saving his tricks to get that spot in the finale. That was so good! If he nails it like he did with me, which I'm sure he will, people will be so pleasantly surprised that he not only has this beautiful, deep voice, but he also has range.
I'm Lauren.
Nice to meet you.
I cannot believe I'm meeting you right now.
Oh, thank you. Lauren chose Wild One by Faith Hill, and I think it's a great song choice for her.
She's a wild one with an angel's face. She's a
I've seen her in the past, and I enjoy her mostly when it's something fun because I feel like it loosens her up. She's a wild
one, ready. Wow, that was amazing. Beautiful job.
I'm so nervous.
Don't be nervous. I'm actually nervous. It's so funny because I've kind of created a character for myself when I perform, because in real life, I'm like, like right before I go on the stage, I tell myself, I deserve it, I'm strong, I'm fearless, I'm a diva, and I would encourage you to do the same because it works for me.
Yeah, I really need to work on that.
I think her nerves are healthy, but when the camera's on and when the pressure's on, that's when you have to perform and deliver. And why did you choose that song?
I chose it because it's just a song that I've been singing since I was a little girl with one of my best friends, and it's just, it reminds me of her. So hopefully tonight when I'm on the stage, I'll be thinking about her instead of all the other 30
million people.
You should just
replace everyone's heads with your friend's head in the audience. It'd be great. It's really so simple to let go and trust yourself. I trust her. I can see that she's incredible, and America can too. So she just has to have that same trust in herself.
Hi again.
I can't wait to hear you sing this song.
Oh, thank you.
So Haley chose What Is and What Should Never Be by Led Zeppelin. It was a very interesting song choice. It just shows her gut. It shows her It shows her strength and her fearlessness. She is a risk taker because she didn't pick a pop song or something that everyone knows. She has conviction. She makes you believe in what she believes in, which is a huge part of being a superstar.
It's been really cool getting to do this song.
Why did you choose this particular song?
Well, I've grown up around classic rock. My parents are in a band together. My dad plays guitar. I'm actually still waiting on to see if he can play this with me tonight.
Really?
Yeah, so it would be really cool.
Oh, that would be amazing.
Yeah, because he rips pretty good.
Wow. I think Haley is a rock star. Haley has a presence. Even when she's not singing, I don't think I've heard anyone like her. Your tone is so warm, and your raspiness is so natural. It's not forced, and you're incredible. Thank you. No handshake.
It's an honor to meet you. I grew up listening to you, honestly.
Thank you.